All right. So I noticed one thing here while sitting there, that there has been substantial decrease in the level of energy we had since the beginning.
Yeah.
So I have a brilliant exercise for you guys, which we are going to practice right now. So I will be telling you first that what to do. Then next, I'll count till three. There are two rules. The game is really simple. That we have to be, the first one is that we have to be accurate. I mean, we have to be together. So make a note of it. And the second one is we have to do it with a lot of energy that this place gets disrupted. All right. So we have to do only this. Besides that, that exercise which we practice right now, there was one more thing. Any guesses? What was that?
No.
Speech?
No.
Deep rhythm.
That was rhythm. There were no musical instruments, no drums, no guitars, no pianos, and we just created a rhythm pattern and we sang on it. So guys, a very warm greetings and salutations, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mayank, and today I'm going to talk about the importance, the how to balance the rhythm of your life. So if you're preparing for any kind of interview, any kind of exam, any kind of, let's say, sports activity, what you're doing, you're basically following a rhythm pattern. And what it is, wake up, practice, go to sleep. Wake up, practice, and go to sleep. Wake up, practice, go to sleep. And you're doing this till the deadline is right. All right. And the bestest example I found regarding this whole rhythm thing is that that thing is present within ourselves, and it is generally on the left side, which is called heart, I guess. So it is constantly following a rhythm pattern, right? So imagine if it misses, if it loses the beat, so what will happen? Will it be any problematic thing? It will be death, man. So now I have got these three things. These three things. If you will master these three things, I'm damn sure that you'll never feel any kind of pressure or any kind of imbalance in your balancing rhythm life. As we all know, that life rhythm got all the ups and downs. So these, beginning with these three things, the first thing comes here are the surprises. Now, how many of us like surprises? Say yes.
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 Bullshit. You don't like surprises that you don't want. You all like surprises that you want. And the surprises that we don't like are called problems. Nobody likes problems. But let me tell you this truth of life, man. That surprises can make you happy for a moment. But problems can help you grow. Problems can initially help you grow. So you can make note of it that problems make you grow. Coming up to the next part is tolerance. Tolerance, or you can call it patience. Now imagine yourself, now how many of us like to wait at the bus stop for the bus? How many of us? Oh, there are many. I was hoping nothing. So how many of us feel like, yes, I'm already half an hour late and the bus is also half an hour late. My boss can kick me out of the office today and I can lose my job, but I'm happy. How many of us feel like this? Oh, really cool. That's the spirit. Because patience is not the ability to wait. Patience is the ability to have a good attitude while you're waiting. Right? Now coming up to the third, last but not the least part is energy. Have you seen a live example right now, how we are feeling right now, energetic? So energy plays an important role. Now imagine it's your wife's birthday and you go to her like, hey, how are you? It's your birthday and we should celebrate. I got a Hey, happy birthday. Let's go to a restaurant. You can probably get divorced instead of that house. So make a note of these three things, guys. These three things can make you reach anywhere in life. So a very thank you so much, guys.